Representative Lucero, if you would stay, since you're here, this is akin to what I was going to say before. I'm going to preface it by trying to clarify this a little differently. Since you work in this field, if you have a significant enterprise, ooh, say the state of Minnesota, and you're in charge of cybersecurity, and you have access to $1.5 million, or you could go ahead and have access to the full $6.5 million, wouldn't the $6.5 million be the better choice for an enterprise of the magnitude if both of these are available at this time?
Mr. Lucero.
Thank you, Madam or Mr. Chair. So potentially, but not necessarily. When it comes to allocating money, you can't just throw money at things and think they're going to fix anything. We have to make sure that money is spent the most efficiently and effectively. And just because you do it in haste, or because you do it in haste, it might end up not being the most effective.
Mr. Chair, if I can follow
Senator
up.
Kemp.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. And I know, Representative Lucero, you're sort of being thrown into the middle of this conversation, but I will just reiterate what Secretary of State Simon went through at great length and has given us a lot of documentation in terms of the working groups that have been working on this issue and have enumerated what would go into this. And ultimately, what my original point was, and thank you for putting up with my question in this particular context, Representative Lucero. When we had the opportunity in the spring of 2018 to go ahead and authorize the $1.5 million, that was what was available at that time. That number is frankly moot at this point. And I guess my question for Senator Kiffmeyer is, I hear what you're saying in terms of an agreement in the broad strokes of being in the language that was in the omnibus bill that we passed in 2018. But the facts of this matter have changed since then. And I'm wondering, my specific question to you would be, have you spoken to Senator Gazelka and heard specifically from Speaker Hortman that they want to go back to what was old in 2018 as opposed to moving forward with these funds as they stand today?